an unbelievable experience. So King Kong just opened, and I haven't read like the New York Times review, but what I've been told is that it kind of turned into two critics sort of like taking jabs at it, and it kind of like evolved into a little bit of like a snark fest. And so I purposefully did not want to read any of them and don't ever read them. And that started a couple years ago. After you read a review that points out things that you're doing incorrectly or that they don't like you doing, it's hard to like, it's hard to stay focused on it as, mm-hmm. as you go out the next day and do it. So, it's like the following day, it felt like I had caught a disease a little bit. Like friends were texting me like, and sort of cryptically not wanting to mention why, but being like, yo, keep your head up, dude. Like you're doing good stuff out there. It's like, I'm not dead. Like if somebody didn't like my musical, that's cool. Like I'll figure it out. And also I continue to believe in what I believe in and I'll continue to do this. But I think what sort of like summed it up is like my very best friend who I've known since I was 5 years old, Rob Ferrari, and his wife, Mary, who grew up in New Jersey as well. They still live there, have nothing to do with what we do, but Mary is a principal in elementary school. So they came the performance after opening and they had read this review and they were like, hey, man, how's it going in the dressing room afterwards? And I was like, great. You know, I heard we got like trashed and they were like, yeah, you didn't read it. And I was like, no. And we got in this conversation. Why? And then what we sort of concocted, which I love, after we had a couple of drinks in the dressing room and afterwards, the analogy that best fits why not is Mary's in education. And I was like, let's say that you're teaching high school literature, right? And you go in and you feel like you're doing a great job. You do it for a couple of months. Somebody comes and watches you, writes about it. You know, like everybody's read it that you know of. The students that you are teaching have read it. Then you show up and if you read it and it points out something you're doing, it's like, you know, the day was going great for, you know, Mary Ferrari until third period when she tried to explain The Great Gatsby to her students and it turned into some inane rambling and nobody knew what she was talking about. And then go in the next day and teach The Great Gatsby to your students and try to stay focused on what you're doing. Do you know what I mean? And
show business is hard.
Yeah, but ooh. It's also, right, but it's also like it's a selfish protection of your own joy because I'm trying to get better at being an actor and an artist doing this show at the same time as like loving this show. Right. And if I let somebody mess with that, I'm going to let myself down. And that's what this is about for me, is kind of like I can continue to grow in this role and grow as a creative human being, which is why we do this, right?